Hey guys, how's it going?
John here. I got a quick video today. I know I said I wasn't going to do vlogs and stuff like that, but they seem to be really popular with you guys, and you guys seem to enjoy them, so I'm going to keep doing them if you guys like them. This was kind of a touchy subject for me to do. It was about being a parent. I know maybe some of you are younger and aren't planning on having kids anytime soon, but just know that it can happen anytime. And it feels so weird, man. Check this out. I bought this beautiful camera to actually do these vlogs with, I guess you could say. And I can't get the damn footage from that to the editor on my phone to YouTube. BS. Anyway, these are some tips on being a new parent, or what I've noticed in being a parent. Now these are just things that I've noticed, and they may not help you, and they may help you. I don't know. First thing I want to say is, number one, it sounds really simple, and maybe even a little silly, but first thing is breathe. I know that sounds ridiculous, like, oh, I breathe all the time. But what I mean by that is sit down, take a minute, take a breather, assess the situation before you act or react. Get a good handle on things, take a minute, breathe, then react. Don't overreact by going in and freaking out. Just remember, just relax, breathe, take a minute, take a breath, you'll be fine. Number two is support. I don't have these written down in any way. I just have them written down in point form so that I know what the heck I'm talking about and keep myself on track. Number two is support. Support your loved one. Support your partner. When I was told that I was going to be dad, I was shell-shocked. I still am shocked that I'm a dad. But the anticipation of being a dad was much worse than being a dad, if that makes any sense. But it's so important to support each other. You know, your spouse or your partner, the mother, the father of your child, men and women alike. This isn't just for men, it's just for women too. We may act big and tough, but we need support too. You know, we have emotions, we have feelings, and we need help, and we need, a shoulder to cry on too. Most guys won't admit that, but I certainly need the support, just as much as, Jen needs support for me. So, and remember, thirdly, is that this is your child. Okay. It's not the doctor's, it's not your parents, it's not the grandparents, it's your child. Okay, this is important. It's your baby. And you need to remember that, and you need to take responsibility for that. That this is your baby, and you need to remember that it is your baby, that it is your child. This is your responsibility, and you need to step up and meet that responsibility head on. If you don't, you're lost already. If you don't stand up and meet the challenge, you're lost already. You're done. You might as well just forget about it. And two, you're kind of a piece of crap. Like, if you just walk away, like, if you have a child and you literally leave that child, you should be ashamed of yourself. That's all I got to say. And remember that kids are kids. If you see a kid, if your kid is picking up something like this and they're chewing on it and they're, you know, chewing on it or chewing on the wall or chewing on, you know, whatever, pushing on the TV and doing stuff like that, they're kids. They have to learn, which brings me into the next section. They have to learn, or my next point is they have to learn by trial and error, so to speak. Like, you don't want them to get hurt, but you don't want them to be coddled. So they kind of have to learn on their own, but they need to learn in a controlled environment, so to speak. Let's put it that way. In an environment where they're being watched. That way they can learn, and if things do go wrong, they don't get hurt too bad. And that brings me to the next point, which is protectiveness or overprotectiveness or underprotectiveness even. I would consider myself a pretty protective parent. But I don't consider myself overprotective. I am somebody that I was taught, you know, if you fall, you get back up, you know, and that's how you learn. If you make a mistake, you're told how to fix it, and then you don't do that mistake again. If I pulled the TV down on my head, you know, my parents would feel bad, and they would be like, oh my gosh, are you okay? And as soon as I told them that I was okay, they're like, well, are you stupid? You know, like, what were you thinking? Like, it's the TV, you know, I could have killed you. You know, so, like, that's how I was taught. And I know that sounds terrible, but it really wasn't all that long ago where, when you were a child, you could walk to school. Now there's, you know, all of this fear and, you know, stuff where, you know, people are worried about their kids getting grabbed. Well, I mean, yeah, it's possible, but, I mean, you know, it's up to us to be the ones that are nervous and the ones that are scared for our kids, not to stifle our kids. You know, not to restrict the kids to the point where they can't enjoy this world that we have. There's a lot of you that were probably sitting there saying, well, you know, there's threats of terrorism and there's all of this other stuff. And my saying is if you're probably very unlikely that you're going to have a terrorist come through your front door. You know, it doesn't make a lot of sense to have, you know, to try and bust in somebody's door to try to kill six people when, you know, you know what I mean? Like the odds of you actually having a terrorist come into your house are probably pretty thin. The odds of them going to your child's school are probably pretty high. Or a gun-free zone, let me put it that way. I don't want to say your kid's school, because that's going to terrorize and terrify people, so let's not say that. But, you know, like, the odds of bad people happening, they're out there, and it happens, but it's up to us to empower our kids to learn what's right and wrong, to learn how to spot things that just aren't right. You know, everybody has more than six senses, or five senses, you know, because we have a lot of senses that aren't the norm, aren't the normal sight, sound, see, hear, you know, touch, taste kind of deal. We have a lot of other senses. Like, have you ever walked into a room and just knew something was wrong or something was off? Well, I think that's important. And that is a skill. And that is something that needs to be taught to your children. And you need to start young. You need to say, well, you can go and have fun, but process things, analyze things, you know. Don't be scared of things, but know how to react to things. And I guess that would be my big thing on protectiveness, would be to instill the right fears in your child rather than the wrong ones. It's up to us to be the burden of the fear and the responsibility. And that goes back to point number two, which is the support for yourself and your mate or your partner. It's up to the two of you to deal with it. You know what I mean? And not stifle your child and know that your child has a good head on their shoulder because you put that head on their shoulder. So that's kind of important. And be a parent your way. As silly as that sounds, how many people have been pushed away from a relationship because they're expected to be something that they're not? I'm very lucky in the aspect that I am allowed to be a parent my way. I am allowed to be the father to my daughter the way that I am comfortable and the way that I feel is best for me. Obviously, it needs improvement. Obviously, anything can use and need improvement. But I'm very lucky that I am allowed to be the dad that I want to be, rather than being forced to fit in this mold and be, you know, forced to act a certain way. If there are anything that come from Jen or anybody like that, it's always in terms of a suggestion. It's never, you should do this, you have to do that. It's always a suggestion. And that's how it should be. You should never be telling somebody anything. You should always be suggesting something. And you know, like, we're really good at supporting each other in decisions and stuff like that when it comes to Caprice. So that's it. Those are just a few things that may help you get you through the first couple of years of your child's life, and I'm right there with you. So as I learn, maybe I can pass some more knowledge on to you guys. But just remember, breathe, support your wife, support your husband, support your lover, support your girlfriend, support your boyfriend. Remember that this child is your child. Step up, take responsibility, do what you need to do. It's your child. Okay? Remember that. Remember to let your child be a child. Do not stifle them. Let your kid be a kid. When they're 1 and 2, they need to fall down and get some rug burn and stuff like that. They need to learn that stuff. Protect yourself, protect your family. Don't be too overprotective. Bear the burden yourself. Don't put that burden onto your child. And be a parent your way. If there are certain things that you're not capable of doing or not able to do, step up and do things in other ways. Do things in other ways, but be there. Be available. Be available at any time that you can. And that's it, you know, like those are just some little helpful tips that help me get through and help me do certain things. So I would like to thank you guys so much for watching the video. And if you guys like these videos, please leave me a comment. I want to know. I want to hear from you guys. If you watch the video, take a few seconds to leave a comment, you know. Let me know if you like these types of videos, because if you do, I got a lot of shit rolling in my head, man. Like, I can make these videos every day, you know. I mean, if these are the type of videos that you guys would want to see, with maybe a couple of gaming videos thrown in, then that's what I'll do. Then these are the videos that I'll make, and I'll make them for you guys. So let me know in the comments, and let me know on my Facebook, because I'm going to be posting it on my Facebook, so let me know there too. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. I'm out.